Good evening and welcome to St. Bernard's. Tonight we celebrate the Most Holy Trinity. Please stand and join us in singing our entrance hymn, number 637, This Day God Gives Me, verses 1 and 3.
Forerunner of his prodigies of long ago. From of old, I was poured forth at the first, before the earth. When there were no depths, I was brought forth. When there were no fountains or springs of water, before the mountains were settled into place, before the hills, I was brought forth. While as yet the earth and the fields were not made, nor the first clods of the world, when the Lord established the heavens, I was there. When he marked out the vault over the face of the deep, when he made firm the skies above, when he fixed fast the foundations of the earth, when he set for the sea its limit so that the water should not transgress his command. Then was I beside him as his craftsman, and I was his delight day by day, laying before him all the while, playing on the surface of the earth, and I found delight in the human race. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, I have much more to tell you, but you cannot bear it now. But when he comes, the Spirit of truth, he will guide you to all truth. He will not speak on his own, but he will speak what he hears, and will declare to you the things that are coming. He will glorify me, because he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. Everything that the Father has is mine. For this reason I told you that he will take from what is mine and declare it to you. The Gospel of the Lord. In 1997, a 14-year-old student at Eagle Rock Junior High School in Idaho Falls won the first prize at the Greater Idaho Falls Science Fair by showing how conditioned we have become to those who spread fear about everything that is happening in our environment. In his project, the young man urged people to sign a petition demanding strict control or total elimination of the chemical dihydrogen monoxide, because he said this chemical can cause excessive sweating and vomiting. It is a major cause of acid rain. It can cause severe burns in a gaseous state. It has, if it is an accidental inhalation, it can kill you. It contributes to the erosion of our natural landscape. It decreases the effectiveness of automobile brakes. And so he asked 50 people if they supported the ban on dihydrogen monoxide. 43 said yes, 6 were undecided, and 1, only 1, knew that the chemical dihydrogen monoxide is water. Yes, water. They were going to ban water because, well, it was a major cause of acid rain, and could cause severe burns in a gaseous state, and it can contribute to the erosion of our natural landscape. Water. It gives us some idea that when we want the truth, we look to science. We think of science as being the source of all truth, but we know in our own time there are so many different interpretations of scientific data that those of us who don't have a good head for science can literally find our head spinning when we hear one person quoting one scientific truth and another person quoting a different scientific truth. We want to know the truth when science speaks. We really want to know the truth when anyone speaks. Well, don't we? We're told by Jesus on this Trinity Sunday, but when he comes, the Spirit of truth, he will guide you to all truth. One of the great gifts of the Spirit that we received at confirmation was the Spirit of wisdom. And we've always needed that gift of the Spirit. We've always needed that wisdom as we live our lives day in and day out, but perhaps now more than ever, we need that wisdom. We need that wisdom in an age where there has been an explosion of information, new learning, new discoveries, an exponential increase in the volume of knowledge that's out there. And I don't know if all of the new knowledge that is making us, is it making us wiser, leading us to more truth? Maybe that's why we need the Holy Spirit more and more to guide us into that way of truth. Because that Spirit of truth, Holy Spirit, can cut through whatever is not true, can cut through any bias, can cut through any prejudice, can cut through anything that's perhaps non-objective. The Spirit of truth, the Holy Spirit, can in fact lead us to all truth. And we need that truth. It's kind of a liberating force as well. We know that the Spirit of truth will set us free, and it is that Spirit of truth that will lead us into that place, not only of wisdom, but lead us into that place of greater freedom. We don't need to stand with a truth that gets watered down, we need to stand in the freedom of truth. That is what it is, the truth that stands on its own 2 feet. Not a half-truth, not a distortion of truth, not a watered-down truth. It is that spirit of truth that the Holy Spirit comes to bring us, which really does give us a new kind of freedom. And sometimes that freedom that the Holy Spirit does bring to us, and the truth the Holy Spirit brings to us, can make us uncomfortable because it can frighten us in some ways. But we do need to stand in the truth of the freedom that we have been given. Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And if we want to take him at his word, we need to embrace that truth that Jesus and his Spirit and his Father come to bring to us. It's not as if we can say to Jesus, well, yeah, I think mostly what you say is true, or sometimes what you say is true, or when it's convenient, I'll believe what you say is true. When Jesus says, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life, we take him at his word. And so we need to have that kind of freedom the Spirit gives us to stand in that truth of who Jesus is and what he asks of me, what he asks me to do. St. John Paul II very famously said that we are to speak the truth with love, which is what Jesus did all the time. To anyone that he encountered, he spoke the truth to them, but he did it with great compassion, and he did it out of a great spirit of love. And we can think of those occasions when we need to have that kind of truth spoken with love. Don't parents do that all the time? Parents need to correct children. Parents, when they correct their children, do it out of love. And when they're speaking that truth out of love, the child knows that there is love behind whatever truth is being spoken. The child is likely to accept that correction a bit more because they know what's behind it. It's love that is behind it. Another instance of speaking the truth in love is that there are occasions when we need help. All of us have our imperfections. All of us have our weaknesses and our vulnerabilities, and we need to hear the truth spoken to us. There may be, for example, a spouse, a child, a friend, a co-worker, who might say to us, you know, you're drinking too much, you're gambling too much, you're swearing too much, you're spending too much. The list can go on and on, but certainly, we do need others to speak a word of truth to us out of love. And when they speak that word of truth to us out of love, it will in fact free us, give us greater freedom to then do what is right, what the Lord is calling us to do. And perhaps the third time when we need to hear the truth spoken in love is in the sacrament of reconciliation. Because in the sacrament, we come before the Lord to speak truth of our life, and we hear from the priest the truth spoken back to us from the Lord. It's an exchange of that spirit of truth that happens in the sacrament. My brothers and sisters, the gospel today speaks of that spirit of truth that gives us the opportunity then to reflect on the source of truth. Certainly there is great truth in science. I'm not someone who disbelieves. It's very important. It has provided so much for us in our world, in our lifetime, and in our current day. But it just seems that it can run the risk of being sometimes self-centered and having a bias. And so we come really knowing that the spirit of truth that is of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, it is that spirit of truth that will literally set us free and lead us into that greater communion of love with Father, Son, and Spirit, a communion of life, a communion of love, and a communion of truth. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Secure in the knowledge that God the Father loves us, we bring our needs before him, confident that he will listen to our prayers.
That the Church throughout the world may arouse in the hearts of all people a deeper understanding of God as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that they may work diligently to promote the cause of peace in Ukraine, so that the dignity and safety of all people may be protected. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those preparing for marriage and for all married couples, that their love for each other may reflect the divine love of Father, Son, and Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers of our parish circle of prayer and for all those impacted by coronavirus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Thomas Walsh, for whom we offer this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God, pour forth your love into our hearts so that we may come to a deeper knowledge of the mystery of your life as revealed to us in the Holy Trinity. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. O God, who in the offerings presented here provide for us the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation, through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Bernard, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, Robert, his assistant, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, we remember Thomas Walsh. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Pray an act of spiritual communion for those at home. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you are already there, I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. So let me never be separated from you. Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord. Just a few announcements. We thank you for your weekly contributions. It's wonderful, your support of the parish. Baskets are at the doors. Take home a copy of the bulletin. It's time to register for faith formation for the fall. So see the bulletin if you're in that category. If you're in that category, the young families and children and the parish, you register now. Take care of that so they know what materials to order. All of that information is in the bulletin. Also, you'll find a list of the teachers, the catechists. We are very grateful to all of them who helped us really pass on the faith to the young people of the parish. So thank you for any catechists who are here. We listed all of their names for their good work during the past year. We're going to have altar server training on Saturday, June 25th at 10 a.m. Anyone who's made First Communion and older is eligible, so you can call to register. Congratulations to the Progressive Jackpot raffle winners. Their names are in the bulletin. They maybe will take you out for a cup of coffee. Check with them. They have winnings. Last Saturday, we had a wonderful celebration with the St. Bernard Award, and in the vestibule is a photo of the sisters who were here, and Sister Una, Sister Bernadette, if you were able to join us, but a wonderful celebration. So take a peek at that on your way out. Our altar is adorned with flowers, and the reason is kind of the somewhat sad occasion of three funerals during the past week, three of our parishioners. So we keep all of the families of those who have died in our prayers and thank them. The flowers are beautiful, sign of new life. But we pray for all of the families who had funeral masses during the course of this week. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
As we go forth, please join us in singing our recessional hymn, number 22, Holy God, we praise thy name.